again for this awesome day. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are with us, that yes. there is nothing impossible for you, Father. We thank you that you are organizing your preparation for your people, Father God, as your people come together, Father God, in worshiping you. Lord, that you would make a way where there seems to be no way, that you would make a river in the desert, Father God, that there would be a flowing amount of water, Father God, flowing out of our hearts, Father God, in worshiping you, that we would worship you in spirit and in truth, Lord. We love you. We thank you for this wonderful day. We thank you for those that are present here today and for those that couldn't make it yet, Father God, but they will make it, Father. Yes. But anyway, we ask you, Lord, that you'd be with them, protect them, keep them safe, and pour out your anointing upon them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That beautiful prayer. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. You're welcome. Praise God.
Yeah, what happens this week actually is very slow. But I wasn't been able to go to the church this Sunday. So I was very slow. Really, if you didn't go to your church, it's affects the whole day, the whole week, actually.
And no, it that's seems my that way.
Experience. And every time. And it's every time. So
it seems that way. But don't blame it on God.
Of course, yeah. I blame it on myself.
Yes.
Praise God, yeah. But so far, yeah. God is in control.
Yes.
And always reading my Bible every day. So I still remember my First Corinthians 15:58. So yeah, just cling unto him. So any word of encouragement, Pastor Tony?
Yes, it's not coming from me, but coming from the Lord.
Amen.
Matthew 6:25-27 says, therefore, I say to you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food and a body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air, for they neither sow nor reap, nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not more value than they? Which of you, by worrying, can add one cubit to his stature? No, sometimes we need to remind ourselves of this. Sometimes we always worry about things. We even worry about things we don't know. And it's not the only reminder we'll find in the Bible. There are several reminders in Scripture telling us not to worry, and that peace is only found in Jesus. Yes, just like Pastor Thomas's prayer, only found in Jesus. He knew his Father, and he knew that his Father had a plan. And the best of all is that he trusted him. Jesus trusted God. Why can't we? Why won't we?
That's right.
Worrying is a man's expression of distrust in the Lord. That's what it amounts to. And most often, it's not because of God. It is because we choose to rely instead on ourselves. Yes, oftentimes we forget to go to God first. This is the root cause of man's stressful times and not finding lasting peace. When we are worried, stressed, and filled with anxiety, you know, going to the Father in prayer and asking for his help,
amen, that's right,
will always give us peace. Peace that only he can provide. We don't have the ability nor the wisdom to provide the peace we're looking for. We might be able to momentarily, but it's not as lasting as God's peace, peace that transcends our understanding. You can pick up any Bible version or any dictionary version. Find all the good adjectives you can find in that dictionary, put them all together. That will still not be enough. Won't be enough to give us the peace that we're looking for. It never will. Only God can provide us the peace that we're looking for and will satisfy us for a long, long time. That's it. That's all I have for everybody. And I wish that helps somebody.
Amen. Thank you. Yes.
Pastor Thomas, any word encouragement for us today?
I'm going to use John 18, verse 37, because Jesus was talking to Pilate, and Pilate was questioning him, said, "Are you the king, or are you a king?" Put it that way. Are you a king then? And Jesus answered, "Thou sayest, I am a king. Thou sayest that I am a king. To this end was I born, and for this cause I came into the world, that I should bear witness unto the truth. Everyone that is of the truth hears my voice." Yes. So sometimes we are blinded. You know, if you are not born again, you can read the Bible, but you don't really get anything out of it. But it's only when the Lord opens our eyes and opens our hearts that we can actually hear his voice. And those that are seeking the truths, those that seek to know him, and when we're ministering to people, we pray that their eyes would be opened, that their hearts would be opened, that they would be able to hear the voice of the Lord. Because if they're seeking the truth, and there's a lot of deception in this world, but we pray that the truth will be known. Because when we're out there witnessing to people, we're sharing the love of Jesus Christ. It's the truth that they need to hear and understand, that Jesus Christ came into this world, that he not only died for our sins, but he rose again, and he came to be the king of all, you know, not just the king of the Jews or the king of the Greeks, but he came to be the king of all. And so today we can look to him as our king, because he overcame the powers of darkness. And because he overcame the powers of darkness, by us seeking his face, we will overcome the power of darkness also.
Yep. Amen. 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 Thank you. Amen.
You're welcome.
Deepa.
Pastor Laman, any word of encouragement from Jerusalem, Israel?
Well, the peace, it came from the Lord. No one can give us the real peace like the Lord Jesus Christ. He's the one and Alpha and Omega. Even the freedom doesn't come by any authority or government or any one, but came from above. If we don't have the real peace from God, we cannot have it from anyone.
Amen. Yes.
Amen.
Agreed. Yes. I believe that.
Very good. That's true.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Pastor Emmanuel, any word of encouragement, Pastor Emmanuel?
Yes. God is good. He's doing very wondrous things in India. And we are able to go to the prison and conduct a Bible study. And there are three criminals accepted Jesus, ready to take the baptism. That is the good news.
Praise God.
And, yes, sir. And a gypsy family. There are two gypsy families we are studying Bible with. And they are open to the gospel. And we are studying the Bible with them. We are discipling them. They are very much interested to know Jesus Christ. And we are explaining about Jesus to them. Pretty soon, they are going to accept Jesus. And then we will have two families come together, come to know Jesus through gypsy families. Wow. Through those two families, we will reach the entire gypsy community. So that is the good news. And please pray for us and pray for us to be safe from the Delta virus, Delta plus virus. We need your protection. We need your prayer. Please pray for the edge of protection on each and every one of us. The word of encouragement today is we have to look unto Jesus. As Hebrews chapter, the last chapter we will see that we have to look unto Jesus even though the trials and troubles come on our way and distract us from walking with the Lord. But still we need to focus, fix our eyes on him and look unto him. Whatever comes, even if the problem comes, still we have to walk with him. And even though some things distract us, but still we need to fix our eyes on Jesus and Amen. We have to look unto him. So this is the word of encouragement. That is what the Lord puts on my heart this morning.
Praise God. Thank you, Pastor.
Amen.
Amen.
I have a short testimony to share too as well. I forgot, I wasn't going to share it, but I think it's a good idea. So just to give you some background, my son was in the military for 14 years. And of course, you know, he always called me up before he went into battle because he knew that, you know, we can pray and he would be protected by the Lord's hand. And so many times he would be faced with, you know, people shooting against him, but he would not be injured. Excuse me. And then he was one time in we prayed for hours. I could hear them calling in the background, Benjamin, you need to get some sleep. Benjamin, you need to get some sleep. Well, I told him, I said, just keep praying. If the Lord has it on your heart, you just keep praying until we get a breakthrough. So we did. And one time he went out on a mission. He was in this room. It was like an open windows. It was a compound and a hand grenade flew in the window. And when it flew in the window, it was a dud. It landed within 3 feet of them. Wow. But within a few seconds, I should say, another hand grenade came in the window and it rolled right next to the other one. And so when that one goes off, it will ignite the second one. And so what happened is it blew off, but it was like there was a shield of protection around them. And so they were not injured whatsoever. In fact, my son called me up. He said, Dad, for the first time in my life, I saw a unilateral hand grenade. It blew up away from us and it blew out the wall away from us, but nobody was hurt. It was like a glass shield of protection. And so that reminded me of God's hand of protection over our lives, how well he protects us and keeps us safe. How many times have we prayed for someone to get healed and they got healed, or we were healed because we saw God's hand over our lives and we had to stand in faith? And standing in faith doesn't mean praying one little prayer. We prayed for hours until we were exhausted. We finally, you know, said, you know, it's either we're going to be exhausted or he has to go on his journey, you know? And so we didn't just pray a little sweet little prayer and that was it. But the question that I see here is that it's all by faith. You know, yeah, you could pray a short prayer if you have the faith to believe that, that's good. Then you pray that short prayer. But in some cases we have to pray longer and it's okay because we have to remember everything is by faith. We put our faith in Jesus. Our faith is not in ourselves or our prayer or our ability, but it's in the Lord Jesus Christ. And so everyone that puts their faith in Jesus begins to see a miracle. So this week, my son called me up and he was telling me about, he was living in this little apartment with two daughters and his wife after getting out of the military for 14 years. And his wife at that time for years, she did not believe in Jesus. She just had a hard time. So one day he took her to a church and they began to preach about the gospel and they began to tell her about Jesus. And she began to hear the message. She came home and she read the book of Genesis from cover to cover. in one night, in one sitting, because she was hungry. And then she began to read the word, and she began to go back and hear more and more. Finally, they were all, the whole family was baptized on the same day. They were all filled with the Spirit on the same day. They all began to see the miracle of God. And just this week, somebody gave them a house to live in, which is, you know, would have cost $600,000. But it was just the miracle of God. And you know, it's something like that. When you press in to see to know the Lord, and you have faith to believe him, it doesn't matter what happens. He will take care of us. And he will always provide for our needs according to his riches and glory.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank
You're
you.
You're welcome.
Pastor Jonah, Bishop Juniper, any word of encouragement, Bishop?
Praise God, because the government extended our MECQ up to the end of the month, so we're still locked down. But because they say the COVID thing is getting higher in Rizal Province, but praise God, our family is not affected. And thank you also for the prayers, because last week I told you that my blood pressure shoot up because of my I think it's because of my vaccine. And praise God, because just this morning my wife is having her therapy with her knee in the physical therapist, and you know, my wife told about my situation last week, and it was confirmed. 3 patients of the medical doctor in the physical therapy clinic had the shoot up of their blood pressure because of the COVID vaccine also. So my wife is told me that she's very sorry, because all the while she thought I'm just having a psychosomatic reaction, but it's confirmed that there are many patients, because I have comorbidity. I have high blood pressure, and I think those people with high blood pressure are not supposed to have vaccine, because the medical doctor, the physical therapist, is telling my wife that be careful with choosing your vaccines. So please pray for me, because I'm having my second dose. I'm having second thoughts of having my second dose on September 21. Because until now, I am still nauseous. So, but the high blood pressure is already controlled. Because before I'm only taking 50 milligrams, now I'm taking 100 milligrams after the vaccine. So if I'm going to take the 50 milligrams, we tried when I started having the 100 milligrams of losartan. Now it's already controlled. So pray for us. Me and my 3 daughters got that vaccine, the Pfizer. My 3 daughters don't have, because they are still young, but maybe because I am having my cholesterol maintenance, my high blood maintenance, and so maybe that's the reason why. And we praise God, because I didn't have the most of the patients have the facial paralysis because of those that and it's, I think it's not a coincidence, because if only one, it's coincidence, and if only two, another coincidence, but we are 4 that is reported here in our place. So, and maybe there are some poor people that had the vaccine that was not able to go to the physical therapist, and they just ignore what they are feeling. So, please continue to pray for us. Continue to pray for the Philippines. And dengue and COVID are rampant now in the Philippines. Pray for us.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Yep. So since I called in Pastor Augustine, I think he's not coming in today. So yeah. Well,
so maybe Bishop Jennifer can sing a song then.
Yeah. Bishop Jennifer, can you render us a song?
We can share one song. I prepared a Tagalog song, but it has lyrics on it. It says that the Lord knows who we really are, and the Lord knows whatever we need and whatever is our situation. And I want to share this verse in 2 Chronicles 15:7. But you, be strong and do not let your hands be weak, for your work shall be rewarded. So let's listen to this song.
May alam ng aking patutunguhan. Salamat sa iyo, Panginoon. Salamat, Panginoon, kilala mo ako. Ang lahat ng bagay ay lilingid sa'yo. Salamat, Panginoon, tinutuwid mo ako. Ikaw lang ang may alam ng aking patutunguhan. Salamat sa'yo. Salamat sa'yo. Salamat sa'yo, Panginoon.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord.
Pastor Tony will explain it in English.
Kumbinsado na akong kumbinsado na akong Pilipino ka.
Rizal, Pastor, eh, taga original
Pastor
na
Pastor Tony, explain niyo po sa yan. English.
Original from Rizal. So, you know.
Rizal, ha? Yeah, Rizal. Sa Rizal, Antipolo, Cainta?
Angono po, Angono.
Yeah. Angono.
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 Yeah. Original.
I'm down south of Angono. Muntinlupa. You heard of Muntinlupa?
Yeah, it's 45 minutes away from us.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. I'm from Sukat, Muntinlupa. That's where I was born and raised.
Yeah, it's only 30 minutes because we already have the C6.
Oh, C6 is complete?
Yeah, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Before we will travel for almost 3 hours there. But now
That's
only 30 minutes.
30 minutes?
Yeah.
From Angono?
Yeah, via Laguna Lake.
Yes.
Coastal road.
By the side of Laguna of
Ladway?
Yeah. Ladway, yeah.
Yeah, Ladway. Yeah.
That's great. You go through Bikutan and...
Yeah, via Laguna Lake Coastal Road.
Coastal Road, yeah. How far does that coastal road go now?
When you go to Lower Bikutan, that's the start of the coastal road. From Lower Bikutan to our place is only 15 to 20 minutes now.
Wow. That used to take hours.
Yeah, that.
Yeah, lower
before
Bikutan,
it's two hours to 3 hours.
Yeah, Lower Bikutan is next to that is Bagumbayan.
Yeah, and then Sukat.
And then Sukat, yes.
Yeah.
I used to walk from one end of Sukat to Bagumbayan and back.
To yeah. The small bridge.
Yes, yes. Actually, it's a bridge that separates every barangay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amen. Okay. Yes, I am happy that God knows me too. I'm happy in a way and scared in a way. Because I can't keep a secret from God.
Amen.
You know, the more He knows
everything.
But I'm happy that He knows me.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Because, yeah.
My prayer is that my whole family will know them, will know him also.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen. Okay, we'll pray. Everybody will pray. And Pastor Tony will be the last one and will be the will close the Bible study today.
Yes.
So yeah, I will start and the rest will be next. Lord, thank you so much, Lord, for this day, Father God, for bringing us all together, Father God, today. from India, from Israel, Father God, from Philippines, here in America, Father God. Father God, use me, Lord Jesus. I'm waiting for you, Lord Jesus, what you're going to do with my life, Father God. I pray, Father God, this is an opportunity for me to come and worship you, Lord Jesus. Every day, Father God, I pray, Lord Jesus. Every day, Father God, I come to you, Lord Jesus. Use me, Lord Jesus, for your kingdom, for your glory, Father God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Pastor Manuel?
Our Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for your love. Thank you for the mercy, tender mercies, the loving kindness, and your grace is sufficient to all of us. Thank you for the edge of protection on each and every one of us in this Zoom meeting today. I pray for Ruben. I pray for brother in Israel. I pray for Bishop Jonavir. I pray for Dr. Thomas. I pray for Pastor Tony and Pastor Ben in Africa, and each and every one of us. Bless our families, bless our ministries, and bless the ministry in Philippines and India, Israel, Africa, California, USA. Yes. And Lord, thank you for bringing us together, Lord. Lord, help us to look unto you, whatever comes on our way.
Yes, sir.
Whatever distracts us, even though something distracts us from walking with you, help us to fix our eyes on you. Yes. Help us to look at you, Lord Jesus. Help us to look unto you for all the days of our lives. Yes. And whatever we speak, help us to honor your name. Help us to bring honor to your name, Lord. Thank you for this fellowship. Thank you for this fellowship that we are able to sharpen each other, help each other, strengthen each other. And also we pray for the team pastors in India as they're working very hard, day and night, taking the gospel of Jesus Christ to the people in the villages. Bless them, Lord, and keep them safe from Delta Plus virus. And also we pray for edge of protection on each and every one of us. And our family members, and our team members, our church members.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, please anoint us. Please anoint us with your special anointing so that we may share your love with others. Thank you, Lord, for this Zoom meeting. This Zoom meeting is so much it is a blessing to me. I have been blessed by these Zoom meetings.
Yes,
and I am so much encouraged. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for this time. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Pastor Jonaber, Bishop Jonaber.
Yeah, Heavenly Father, we praise you for this evening. We thank you for the opportunity that we were able to pray for each other, and we were able to share our burdens and also our verses that would strengthen everyone. I continue to pray for the good health of Pastor Thomas, Lord. Even in his senior days, Lord, continue to use him mightily, Lord, in your ministry, in your kingdom, Lord. And also, I would like to pray also for Pastor Tony, together with his congregation in Japan. Continue to bless the congregation, and also his prayer request for his family to know Christ, and also, Lord, for the protection for him and her wife, Lord, against the virus, Lord. I also continue to pray for Pastor Emmanuel. Continue to provide for his ministry, especially in their place. Continue to bless those people, those members that he's been taking care of. And, Lord, continue to strengthen him, Lord. And also our brother, Lord, in Israel. Lord, continue to bless him, Lord, especially now that they are always in turmoil because of those nations that wanted to get Israel from them, Lord. Continue to protect the whole family, Lord, and also the whole congregation. In Jesus' name, I also continue to pray for Kuya Ruben. Continue to bless the vision that you gave him, Lord. Continue to prosper him, especially the business that you entrusted him. Continue to protect the business against bad people, and also continue to comfort him whenever he's lonely, especially he's still single. Continue to bless him together with his fiance that is located here in the Philippines. And Lord, we're praying that the pandemic will be lifted up and will be finished so that they could see each other, Lord. Thank you very much for your love to each and every one of us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Pastor Laman.
Amen. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this moment. We thank you, Lord, for your grace and your mercy. We thank you, Lord, for my brothers and sisters, for each one who are praying right now with me, Lord, and to trust that your Holy Spirit working with us, Lord Jesus. And I pray that the Philippines, India, America, Israel, Palestine, West Bank, whatever, any countries belongs to you. Whole the world belongs to you, Jesus Christ. We declare that you are the one, the mighty God, who can move and change everything from darkness to light. You are the mighty God, and nothing impossible unto you. I pray, Lord, for my brothers who are on the Zoom right now. I pray for each one of us, Lord, that you give us more wisdom, how we can handle it, to serve you, Lord, and to love you from all our bottom of our hearts, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for this moment that we are spending time together to glorify your holy name. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for your love. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Pastor Ben just came in. So, Pastor Ben, we're doing the closing prayer now. So, you wanna start giving us a prayer to be closed by Pastor Tony later on and Pastor Thomas.
Sorry for the bad signal, but I've joined you. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, we bless you, we honor you. Thank you for this wonderful fellowship and your servants who are working to serve you, O God. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness, for your protection, and for your mercies. Father, we pray even for the pastors. We pray even for your servants in this fellowship and the churches and the ministries around the world where they are serving. The Lord, you continue to protect them from COVID-19 and their families as they serve you in the name of Jesus. May you ignite them with the fire of your Holy Spirit to serve you, to bring even souls to your kingdom, because you are God and there is none like you. We thank you because you are Jehovah Jireh. You'll meet with the needs of your servants and the needs of these ministries and these pastors and these bishops and this fellowship, because you are faithful and there is none like you. We rebuke the devourer. We rebuke the devil. He has no power in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We love you and we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Pastor Thomas?
Yes, thank you. Heavenly Father, I just stand in agreement with each one of these ministers, Father God, in their prayers, Father God. Your word, which we believe, Father God, as we stand together, for your word says that where two or more are gathered together in your name, there you are in the midst of us. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for being our King and our God. We thank you for being our healer and our provider. We thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayers and answering them, Father God. We cover each and every one of these pastors, Brother Pastor Lamont and all the pastors, Father, present here, Father God, including Pastor Tony, including Pastor Emmanuel, and also Brother Pastor Ben, as well as Brother Reuben and myself as well, Father God, but we cover each and every person here, Father God, in the name of Jesus. We pray, Lord God, that your word, which we have heard today, will remain with us, Father God. We thank you, Lord God, that you are almighty. We thank you that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. We thank you for the miracles that you are doing right now, Father God, even in the midst of the COVID virus, Father God, in the midst of a pandemic, Father God, in the midst of darkness in the world. We thank you that you are the light. We thank you that you have given us the authority and the power, Father God, invested into us by your Holy Spirit to preach the gospel, Father God, to be able to do that which you have anointed us to do, Father God, to serve you and to serve your people, Father God, to be a vessel of light to the world, Father God. We pray, Lord, that your miracles would begin to happen, Father God, around the world and in the various places where your church is preaching the gospel, Father. We pray, Lord Jesus, that your word will go forth like a two-edged sword, that people will fall upon you, that they will just come to know you and trust in you. And I pray for that miracle, Father God, for each and every one of our congregations, Lord, that everyone we speak to, Lord God, will be drawn to you in a mighty, mighty way. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Dear Father in heaven, we know and we admit we have not the power, we have not the wisdom, we have not the energy, we have not the ability and control of anything, but we believe you do. So Father, we are entrusting everything to you, Lord God. For you are the one, you are the Almighty, and no one else. Mm-hmm. And you're always in control. Father, we come to you humbly, asking for your help, asking for your guidance. Be our guide, be our guard. For the rest of our day today, Lord God, we pray that you would make it possible for us to make use of the hours remaining, that we may prosper and further and share your gospel to people around us, beginning with our loved ones, our friends, our workmates, and people that we associate with on a daily basis. We ask you, Father, Lord God, to just act through us. We humbly submit ourselves to you, whole stock and barrel, that you may use us, that you may direct us, and that you may complete the task that you have given us, that you may accomplish the purpose that you have called us to. For pastors, teachers, Amen. Counselors, Amen. Or just a friend to someone. We thank you, Father, Lord God. We fully submit ourselves to you, for you are the Almighty, the one who knows, the one who loves, the one who cares, the one who had made the sacrifice, the ultimate sacrifice, that you gave your only begotten Son to suffer on the cross, die, buried, and on the third day rose again. That greatest ever miracle that you have ever performed had only one purpose, and that purpose is to give us life, not only life, but eternal life, and to give us forgiveness, that we may be able to come to you anytime. We thank you, Father, Lord God. Help us to keep that in mind and always be mindful of the sacrifice that your Son had done for us. We thank you, Lord God, and we pray that you would continue this platform everywhere, Lord God, not only for us, for this group, but for every other group that's taking advantage of the internet waves to come together. Although miles and miles apart, we're still together because you bring us in the powers of the internet that only came from you. We did not invent the internet. It came from you. You have imputed it in man's brains, wisdom, that we may be able to do all of this that we are doing right now, despite our separation, physical separation. And we thank you, and we recognize your power. You truly are always in control. Not a second that you lost control. We love you. We praise you. We glorify your holy name, dear God, even in the midst of all these trials that we go through every day. We know that we will overcome because you have made us overcomers. Not victims, but victors. Thank you, Father, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Have a great day.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Praise God.
Praise Amen. God. Amen. You too.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank we'll you. Get together sometime, Bishop Jonover.
Yeah. Thank you, Pastor Tony. Shabbat Shalom to everyone.
Shabbat Shalom.
Say hello to our friend, Bishop Noel Pantoja.
Yes. Yes, opo. September 19 po magkakasama kami.
Oh, ganon. Wow, say hello to him for us.
Yes po, yes po.